The mysteries of the sea and its secrets have long fired man's curiosity. Tales of lost treasure ships and the strange marine animals living in the world beneath the waves have spurred him on in his quest to penetrate the barrier and explore the unknown depths. And his attempts have been recorded on the pages of history from early times. Invention of the aqua lung, however, the underwater world has been dramatically opened up to anyone willing to accept the challenge, and increasing numbers of enthusiasts are journeying to our coasts each year to dive. The passion felt by so many for the sport is infectious. And anyone showing the slightest interest, however casual, is welcomed either as a possible convert or at least as a kindred spirit to whom one can recount past experiences and so live again those all too short excursions underwater. Unlike most other sports, skin diving is carried out in a hostile environment. So in order to survive, it is absolutely essential that the novice fully understands the functions and limitations of his equipment and is completely familiar with its use before venturing into open water. This is best achieved by training through the British Sub Aqua Club, the governing body for the sport in this country, whose 200 branches are spread throughout the United Kingdom and the Commonwealth. Initially, training is carried out in the safe confines of a swimming pool, where the pupil first learns to use the basic equipment, consisting of a mask permitting clear vision underwater, a snorkel allowing easy breathing on the surface, and fins giving added thrust and mobility. When the use of this equipment is mastered, the pupil progresses to the aqualung. The aqua lung consists of a high-pressure cylinder containing compressed air, a demand valve which reduces the high-pressure air to a breathable level when required and incorporates a cylinder contents gauge, breathing tubes, and a harness fitted with a quick-release fastening for safety. There is a quick-release weight belt, which is needed to neutralize the positive buoyancy of the human body and the cellular neoprene suit, essential protection against the cold waters around our coasts. Once underwater, training begins. And the program is designed to give the pupil confidence in the equipment and the ability to use it safely in open water. Mask clearing, tube clearing, and sharing the aqua lung are essential exercises to be practiced until using the equipment becomes second nature and the pupil is as much at home in the water as on land. final exercise to demonstrate the lessons learnt. As a result of thorough coaching, the trainee now shares the same skills and confidence underwater as the instructor, although fitting all the equipment while submerged prevents her from sharing her instructor's well-earned break for refreshment. To supplement the pool training periods, pupils also attend a series of lectures on the technical and physiological aspects of diving. With the theoretical and practical training program successfully completed, the pupil is ready for her first open water dive. At last, the time has come when the pupil can put into practice the lessons learned whilst under instruction. As the boat steams towards the diving site, preparations for the day's diving get underway, and all the necessary equipment is checked over and made ready. The diving site is eventually reached. As the boat is anchored in position, the diver's flag is hoisted to show that diving is in progress, indicating to other boats that they should keep well clear. Final preparations are made. A lookout is posted, and a buoy is prepared for streaming astern on a lifeline. last the great adventure begins. Taking part in the sport for the first time, diving offers the excitement of exploring an entirely new environment, so near and yet so completely different from the normal daily round. Here, the pressures of modern living are forgotten as one drifts, gently suspended in a state of neutral buoyancy, so permitting free movement in all directions with a minimum of effort. The only alien sound to disturb the tranquil scene being the noise of the diver's own air, quietly bubbling towards the surface with each exhaled breath. There is so much to fascinate here. Fish dart unconcerned amongst the waving seaweed, crab and lobster lurk, perhaps a little apprehensively in the darker corners of some submarine hideaway, sensing their fate should a diver's quick hand seek them out. The encrusted structure of some long-forgotten shipwreck provides food for the imagination. Sharpened by the knowledge, your eyes may be the first to gaze on these remains since they disappeared under the waves so long ago. And what may still be found lying forgotten amongst the wreckage? The pulse beats a little faster with such thoughts as you venture to explore further. However, diving has become the tool of science. In the field of marine biology, a great deal of research requires observations to be made under natural conditions over extended periods. And today, scientists are making increasing use of divers for this and many other purposes. Marine archaeology, too, already well established in the Mediterranean, is a rapidly developing science in this country. And traces of earlier settlements submerged by the encroaching seas have been rediscovered by aqua-lung-equipped archaeologists, many of them amateurs, trained to observe, record, and photograph their findings. In mentioning only a few of the many diving activities, you will appreciate that the fascination for the undersea world is boundless. So, whatever your reasons, be they purely for pleasure or strictly scientific, one thing is certain. From your first journey underwater, you will enjoy an all-absorbing and rewarding experience which you will be eager to repeat again and again. Pupil seems pleased with her new experience, and to judge by her catch, she has every reason to be. Her instructor has taught her well, and from his expression, perhaps a little too well. So you can see, Fish Sub Aqua Club, using first-class equipment properly maintained, and a strict adherence to the code, the best and only means of ensuring safe and enjoyable diving.
Oh.